very much. Ladies and gentlemen, a warm welcome to each and every one of you. Good evening!
Good evening!
Well, that's a bit posh, a bit polite for a Monday. What about hello?
Hello!
Before we kick things off, turn to the person on your left and say, good evening, how are you? Now turn to the person on your right and say, mind your own business. There's a definite split in the audience. I would say right down the middle here, this side of the room, we've got the young and the good-looking people. So for the young and the good-looking, good evening.
Yeah.
Some of you might want to change sides in a minute. From this side, right around to this end of the room, we have all the rich and the famous. So for the rich and the famous, there. Well, it's lovely to be here, folks. My name's Clark. You're all the way from Dunfermline. I thought, oh no, this guy gets out, I thought he was going to hit me. Tiny wee man, he's like a dwarf. He came up to me and says, I'm not happy. I says, which one are you? The guy answers the telephone and the voice says, hello, is that 777777? He says, yes. He says, can you phone the police? I've got my fingers stuck in the phone. Hey, what's your name in case I don't have time in the cabin? Like a challenge. We're going to have a bit of fun tonight, folks. It's lovely to be. I was actually on the ship 5 months ago. Paul didn't quite realise that. And 5 months ago I was here and I was down in the restaurant, the first night in the Orion restaurant, and I saw the very same waiter that I had 5 months ago. And he came up to me and said, my goodness, I've not seen you for 5 months. He said, I was ever in as fast as I can. And a lovely cabin stewardess, she came in the cabin the first night, she said, Mr. Stewart, do you mind if I come in and clean up? I said, no, please do. She came in, had a shower, did her hair, had these scissors in. First night in my cabin, the phone goes, 2 o'clock in the morning, I got a fright. I thought, who phones the cabin 2 o'clock in the morning? It was the wife. The wife phoned in the cabin. I said, hello, babe. That's what I call it. I call the wife, babe. Have you seen the film? I says, well, you're some concussion, you're a fortune phone in the cab. She says, I'm missing you. I said, I've only been away for a day. She says, I'm lonely. So I thought I'd give her a wee bit of sexy talk, you know, maybe a few jiggles for memories. Do you know what I mean? And you haven't got a clue, have you not? I said, darling, are you sitting by yourself? She says, yes. I said, what have you got one? She says, Coronation Street. Well, if he's an Irishman, he says, well, that's a coincidence, fellas. Here's my son, Pancake. Hello. I got married in the kilt.
Did you really, Clark?
Yes, I got married in the kilt. The minister said you look resplendent, Clark, in your full Highland regalia for your wedding day. He said, if you don't mind me asking, what's your tartan? I said, oh, she's wearing a white dress of a veil. Don't put your pyjama bottoms on. I don't want the neighbours thinking of marrying you for your money.
Pretty Alice fell in love. She planned to marry Job. She was so happy about it all, she told her father so. Her father told her, Alice dear, you'll have to find another. I didn't want your ma to know, but Joe is your half-brother. So Alice put aside her Joe and planned to marry Will. But when she told her father, well, he said, there's trouble still. You can't marry Will, my dear, and please don't tell your mother. But Will and Joe and several more, I know, are your half-brothers. But mother knew and said, my dear, just do what makes you happy. Marry Joe, or marry Will, because your father's not your daddy.
Well, listen, I've got a fact, true. I thought it was for somebody in the first house, but it's not. So there must be the second house. If you're in the room, let me know. It says, dear Clark, please say hello to a very good friend of mine. His name is Stephen Parker. Stephen Parker. It goes on to say, we were supposed to be spending a romantic weekend together, but he decided to go for a cruise with his wife instead. He says, please tell them I love them very much, and I look forward to seeing them back in the office on Monday. That's love from Michael. So, if there's a Stephen Parker in the room, we'll be fine. So I've got also been seeing him at the end of the path, can't see him anyway. I says, hello! He says, hello! I says, where are you? He says, I'm over here on the swings.
In an English hospital, a dying Scotsman lay. His last remaining wish to hear the Scottish bagpipes play. They searched the country far and wide, from sea to shiny sea, and came across a man who played the pipes quite fluently. The piper played from morn till night, and cured, the Scotsman cried. The Scottish pipes have saved his life, and the rest of the patients died.
Excuse me, officer, haven't we met before? He says, no, but I think we go to the same doctor. To this day in Saudi Arabia, girls, ladies only, to this day, if you commit adultery, sorry, I didn't mean to look at you there, myself. To this day, girls, if you commit adultery, you get stoned. In Scotland, we do it the other way around. My face, I'm going to have to shoot you. He says, before I shoot you, I want to know your name. He says to the woman, what's your name? She says, well, my name's Agnes. And the robber starts crying. He says, Agnes, that was my mum's name. I love my mum, I can't shoot you because your name's Agnes. Says to the man, what's your name? He says, oh, my name's Wally, but my pals call me Agnes. Oh, it's not for my arms. He says, where is it for? She says, it's for my chihuahua. He says, well, don't ride your bike for a fortnight. Where's my friend from Scotland? Just over the border of Carlisle, and stopped for one of these old English country pubs. It was called the George and Dragon. The George and Dragon, a big old country pub, the George and Dragon. So I went up to the door, knocked on the door, and this old woman answered. I went, oh, it was Georgian. She said,
appreciation for the music, the quality of Mark Stewart.